Good evening and welcome to PaceIT's class, CIS 205, Technology and Integration Support. And tonight we are going to be covering CompTIA A+, Exam 220-802, Objective 1.3. Objective 1.3 is Introduction to Operating Systems Command Line Tools. And it's where you learn when you should use the appropriate command line tools. So let's go ahead and begin. The first thing we need to talk about is what is a command line tool? It is a utility or set of utilities that are accessed from the command line interpreter, the CLI. They are usually accessed from a command prompt, in most cases from the desktop, but not always. Sometimes there are other environments in which you run command line tools. To reach the command prompt in Windows Vista or Windows 7, you click on the Start button and then you type CMD, which is short for command, in the search box. And that will bring up a command prompt for you. In Windows XP, you click on the Start button, then you click on Run, and then you type in CMD or command in the run box and hit enter, and that will bring you up a command prompt. So now let's talk about command line tools that are used in networking. And one that you should be familiar with is ping. Ping stands for packet internet or internetwork groper. It uses ICMP echo requests and measures the response time. What it is used for is to test for basic end-to-end connectivity between two nodes. It's very useful in testing communications. In its basic format, from a command prompt, you type ping, and then you enter the IPv4 address and hit enter, and you get a response. You can also ping. Type ping and then the domain that you want to ping, like google.com. It can also use various command modifiers. Over here on the right-hand side, you can see where I pinged my router and the response times that I got. Another useful communications tool for networking is Tracert, and Microsoft's implementation of ICMP echo requests that are used to trace or map the route between nodes. Right here we have the tracer from my computer to google.com. It's really useful in being able to troubleshoot network path issues. You can see which path a packet will take to get to its end destination. And by the way, if it doesn't complete the path, the last one listed is not the last router that was pinged or that got the request. It was just happened to be the last one that responded. So the problem lies beyond that one. The way it works is the time to live field on the packet is increased every time a packet is sent out. It does have limited value because a lot of routers nowadays do block those ICMP requests. Sometimes you get lucky and the path is unblocked all the way. Sometimes you don't. So just because it fails doesn't mean that there's a communication problem at that point. It could mean that that router is blocking that ICMP request. So let's talk about next step. From a command prompt, if you type in netstat, you will see all your inbound and outbound TCP/IP connections on a given node. It's really useful when you want to find out what connections are consuming your network resources. It's very good for finding overactive applications or applications that aren't supposed to be communicating that are. If you type net from a command prompt, which you can do is you can map a network resource to a drive letter. That's so if you want to have a network drive, you can use the net command to make that connection. It also has some other great uses. When you get a moment, Google Recover Windows 7 Password, and you'll find out another great way to use the net command. And it's lookup, that is short for name server lookup, and you use that to query the DNS to determine if a record exists. It's how you troubleshoot DNS issues. NBP stat, that's not as common anymore, but you do use it to troubleshoot NetBIOS name resolution issues. So that's on the Microsoft network that's running NetBIOS. If you're having a problem resolving a name, you use NBP stat to do it. One that I tend to use quite frequently is ipconfig. And that way, that is the most basic way to view your IP configuration. It can also be used to set the IP configuration. And it's a good tool to use when you're having networking issues, communication issues. Here's what it looks like from my computer right there. Then we run on to ARP, Address Resolution Protocol. ARP is used to resolve IP addresses, the 192.168.1.yadda.yadda.yadda, to MAC addresses. That's how routers and switches know where to send things. ARP is very useful in helping troubleshoot those. So all these command line tools can be used with optional switches. And you should be familiar with the most common options. So what you can do is you can type in like ipconfig space forward slash question mark, and that will bring up a list of the command line switch modifiers. You can read about them. It's pretty useful. There's some pretty interesting things that you can do in ways that you can change how the command line tools operate. So now let's move on to command line tools that are used in the operating system. And we are talking about Microsoft operating systems. The first one is Taskkill. It is a way to end one or more tasks or processes. And you can kill them by using their process ID or image name. Bootrec is a valuable tool that's available in Vista and Windows 7. It's in the recovery environment. So if you have a computer that won't boot up and you get into the RE, you can use Bootrec to try and fix it. Bootrec forward slash fix MBR will repair a master boot record in case it was corrupted. Sometimes you might need to rewrite a whole new boot record, and that would be bootrec forward slash fixboot. And it will write a new boot record, and then your PC or laptop should fire up no problem. Another command line tool is shutdown. Guess what it does? It will shut down or restart or log off a computer from the command line. So you want to use Taskkill to kill a task, but you don't know its process ID or its image name? Well, guess what? You can use Tasklist, and that will display all the tasks and services that are running and their associated process ID. Sometimes you need to make changes to directories, or you need to make a directory. You can do that from the command prompt with MB, because that makes a directory in the given location. You can use RB to remove a directory, but only if it's empty. There are switches that you can use to modify that. You should know those. CD is another one. These, by the way, are legacy DOS commands. CD will change you to a given directory. So if you type in CD, and then the name of a directory, it will move you to that directory. cd backslash will move you to the root directory. Let's move on. From the command prompt, you can use format, and that's how you use that's used to prepare a disk and to place a file structure on a disk. You use it and when you use it on a disk, it makes data difficult to recover if it was in use before that. Then there's copy. Guess what it does? It copies the source file or directory to a named destination. Xcopy was a newer version, a more robust version with more options, and it's great for copying like a CD to a USB flash. And then there's RoboCopy. That stands for Robust File Copy. It first became available on Windows Vista, and it is the functional replacement of Xcopy. Then you can always use DiskPart. That is an advanced tool to manipulate the hard disk from the command prompt. Anything that you can use from the disk management graphic user interface is pretty much available from the command prompt, from DiskPart. You can actually write some of these things into batch files and automate things quite easily. That way you don't have to be sitting there at the computer. So let's move on to the next one. There's SFC. That stands for System File Checker. You use it to check system file integrity and can be very useful in the recovery process after a virus infection. It can fix some systems files automatically if corruption has occurred. Then there's always check disk. Those of us who have been in this game for a little while understand that check disk checks your hard disk's integrity. It too can be used to recover some corrupted files. As with the networking command line tools, the operating system command line tools also can be used with switch modifiers. And how do you know which switch modifiers are available? That's that /?? Again, that will help you to find those. And now finally, we get to talk about the recovery console. The recovery console first became available in Windows XP, and it was a method of accessing a hard drive in an emergency situation where the GUI would not load. And it presented the user with a command prompt automatically. In Vista and Windows 7, it's no longer called the Recovery Console. It's now called the Recovery Environment. And it's the same basic thing as the Recovery Console. The two most common commands that you'll run from there, well, if you're in Windows XP, it's going to be fix boot and fix MBR. Those are the two most common commands for when a GUI will not load. Because the operating system can't be found, and that's because there's a problem with the boot sector or with the master boot record. If you're using those in Windows Vista or Windows 7, like I said before, then use bootrec/fixboot or bootrec/fixmbr to get you back into the GUI. Those are the command line tools that you need to know for CompTIA's exam 22802. And this concludes our session on that exam, objective 1.3. Thank you for listening, and I'm sure we'll get to do this again sometime. Thank you.